Okay, how are you, students? Previously, we have started discussing on research methods in psychology. Today, I will continue my explanation with regarding to research methods in psychology. As you know, psychology is a science. It employs scientific methods. A scientific method is a method that applies testing different ideas, different thoughts through systematic observation, experimentation, as well statistical analysis. Hypothesis and theory have there is a relationship between a theory and hypothesis. A theory is an integrated set of principles about observed factors that is intended to describe and explain some aspects of experience. So when we talk about theory is an organized set of principles which is checked through research activity. The other important variable which is very known in the area of scientific research is hypothesis. Hypothesis is a tentative proposition or a tentative statement about the connection or the relationship between two or more variables or phenomena. So when we develop, when we construct a hypothesis, we are assuming that this statement or this tentative proposition will be checked out or verified at the end of the research activity. So psychologists mainly use hypotheses to check, to verify different ideas and different concepts. We have examples here. A hypothesis, as I said, is a tentative statement. So I can construct hypothesis in this manner. There is a significance, mean difference between males and females in decision making. There is no significant variation between students and teachers in relation to artificial intelligence concept. There is no significant difference between males and females in relation to adapting new environment. These are some of examples which show hypothesis. So this hypothesis would be checked or verified at the end of the study. Mainly, we have three major types of research methods we use in the area of psychology. The first one is descriptive, second one is correlational study, and the other one is experimental research methods. Of course, other methods would be employed by psychologists. However, mainly the books referred that descriptive method, correlational method, and experimental methods are frequently used by psychologists when they conduct different researches. The first one is descriptive research. The word descriptive refers that the research will going to record ample information about the observed phenomena in a systematic manner. In the case of descriptive research, recording is a major activity, as well as explaining the concept as another activity of the researcher. Under descriptive research, we have naturalistic observation. Naturalistic observation means observe something in the natural setting, not in artificial manner. For instance, if a psychologist wanted to study about sick people, he or she will go in the hospital and investigate the status of their problem. This kind of research is known as what? Naturalistic observation. The other method of research in psychology is case study. Case study is a process of collecting detailed information about a specific case. Oftentimes in case study, we take some individuals, and finally we will come up with generalization. The other types of research is survey research method. In survey research method, large number of individuals or large number of group of people will be involved during data collection period. So survey study assists us to make a generalization, but case study has few number of individuals, but there is detailed information in the case of case study. And in the naturalistic observation, the researcher will go in the actual place and collect information about something which is under study. Okay, the second common method of research in psychology is correlational research. Correlation means it is the relationship between two variables or more variables. So mainly, correlational research focuses on showing the magnitude of the relationship between different variables. When we see the meaning of variable, variable is something or anything that can vary or that can change because of different factors. This is variable. Variable can be a dependent variable or dependent variable or independent variable. For example, the score of the students, the temperature in a particular class or room, gender, age, money. These are examples of variables, whether they decrease or increase because of different factors. These factors may be natural or human-made. So such kind of variation, such kind of differences would be analyzed, would be justified by using correlation. So correlation is one of research methods which is mainly used by the psychologists to show the magnitude or the relationship between either two variables or more than two variables. Moreover, correlational studies or correlational research shows direction. These directions are positive direction, negative direction, constant direction, or zero correlation. What is the meaning of, or what is the concept of positive correlation? Positive correlation means when variable A increases, variable B will be also increases. Such kind of relationship is identified as positive relationship. For example, when your age increases, likewise, if your sleeping power increases, such kind of connection is referring to positive correlation. Whereas when you go to the second kind of correlation, it is negative correlation. When X value increases, Y value decreases, or vice versa. When X decreases, Y will increase. This is referring to negative correlation. It goes in a negative direction. The other one is zero correlation or constant correlation. These kind of correlations are definite and constant in the case of constant correlation. But in the case of zero correlation, we don't know the magnitude, the direction where it goes. For example, when x increases, y decreases. When y increases, x increases. The relationship is not clearly defined in the case of a correlation. So overall, correlation focuses on the relationship as well as the magnitude of their relationship. The magnitude is between positive 1 and negative 1. Positive 1 means perfect correlation, 0 means zero correlation, and negative 1 means negative perfect correlation. However, correlation doesn't verify or doesn't speak about the cause and effect relationship. That is the problem or the drawback of correlational study. For instance, if there is a relationship between smoking and lung cancer, this doesn't mean that smoking is a fundamental cause of lung cancer. This is one of the problems that is observed in correlational study. The other kind of research method we mainly use in psychology is experimental research. Experimental research mainly conducted in the laboratory or in the workshop or in field activity. But in experimental study, there must control group and experimental group to see the effect of the variable or the independent variable or the treatment. Experimental research allows to study the cause and effect relationship. One of the strong sides of experimental research is it shows clearly how far there is a cause and effect relationship between the independent variable as well the dependent variable. So mainly experimental research is conducted with the involvement of independent variables and dependent variable. Independent variable means it is selected by the researcher, manipulated by the researcher. It is influential, which means it has an effect on the dependent variable. And it is experimental factor. The experiment is conducted based on the independent variable. The dependent variable is the factor or the behavior. The dependent variable is the factor or the behavior that is measured after the experiment. So independent variable is a cause and dependent variable is an effect. The reason is that independent variables are manipulated by the researcher. To this effect, dependent variable is measured based on the consequence that is emanated because of the manipulated independent variable. It can change as the independent variable is manipulated. Especially the dependent variable is totally depending on the independent variable. It varies, it changes depending on the independent variable. That is the funny element of experimental research. For example, we can take reading time and students' score. If students read for a long period of time, finally their score, their achievement will be improved. So reading long hours, reading much hours will improve their academic achievement. Hence, we can see that there is a cause and effect relationship between reading and students' academic achievement. Such kind of experiment can be conducted by the psychologists. So, reading time is independent variable, which is manipulated by the researcher. The researcher selecting or scheduling reading time. This treatment will be conducted for a long period of time and its effect will be measured. So this result is called as dependent variable. Okay, when we conduct experimental study, one of the reality is we have to categorize, or we have to have groups. These groups are emanated from the population or the sample. The sample category would be classified into a control group and experimental group. In the control group and the experimental group, many conditions are similar. Experimental group and control group are the same. They have similar characteristics. But the difference is the treatment, which is called the independent variable. So the control group will help us to compare the experimental group. We use classify control group for the purpose of comparing the experimental group and to check the result that will come because of the independent variables which would be manipulated by the researcher. Let me tell you one example. A psychologist was interested to exploring the effect of tutorial to the student's academic performance, and he categorized the students into two groups. The first group is students who get tutorial support. The second group were students who did not get tutorial. Then, after giving tutorial, the teacher, I mean the psychologist, wanted to record the information. Here, the control group is students who did not get tutorial. The experimental group are students who get the tutorial support. This is a control group and experimental group. So that in this case, the independent variable is the tutorial, and the dependent variable is the change of students' academic score. This is the relationship between dependent variable, independent variable, control and experimental group. Lastly, I would like to inform you about the steps of scientific research in psychology. Of course, these steps are common for different fields of study. Similarly, in psychology, whenever we want to conduct a research, we have to follow these steps strictly to make our study, to make our investigation scientific, empirical, and evidence-based. The first step of scientific research is identifying a problem and defining the problem. First, we have to identify critical problem that requires an investigation or further study. After we identify the problem, we have to also formulate hypothesis. As we said before, hypothesis is a tentative statement or a tentative proposition or statement which will be checked at the end of the investigation. Then at the third level, we should test hypothesis. Hypothesis testing will be made based on collecting different data. So data will be collected or gathered by using different instruments. For example, we can use questionnaire, we can use interview, we can use observation, we can use anecdotal record, we can use examination, we can use portfolio, reflection, group discussion or focus group discussion. By using such kinds of instruments, it is possible to collect data and test the hypothesis. After that, we will come to conclusion. Conclusion would be made based on the collected data using different forms of ranges of data collection instruments and data analysis techniques. Finally, the result of the study would be communicated either in the form of presentation, in the form of book, in the form of journal, in the form of report. We can communicate the result for the readers. These are the major scientific procedures of research in psychology. This is what I have about research methods in psychology. Thank you.